Hello, I'm Tanja Säily, Assistant Professor in English Language at the University of Helsinki. This video is about the field of historical sociolinguistics and its relevance to the digital humanities. How does language change happen? Who makes it happen? In 17th century England, during King James's time, people could still say, "The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away," even though the form "taketh" was even then regarded as rather old-fashioned. By the next century, people had almost exclusively switched to the new form, takes, like Hester Piozzi here. The fog takes away all taste of going out. Historical sociolinguistics can help us to uncover the social contexts in which a linguistic change happened, like the individuals and social groups who were at the forefront of the change, and possible external events that may have sped up or slowed down the change. Using methods from corpus linguistics, we can get a quantitative overview of the language change over time in large electronic text collections. And when we combine this with a qualitative study of the texts, aided by historical research and contemporary sources, we're able to interpret the change in its socio-historical contexts. More generally, historical sociolinguistics is concerned with relationships between the individual, language, and society in the past. As you might imagine, it's an inherently multidisciplinary subfield of linguistics. In addition to fields like social history and corpus linguistics, it's related to historical linguistics and sociolinguistics, among others. In fact, it started out as an experiment. Can we test the claims made by present-day sociolinguists on historical materials, where we have access to centuries of real-time change? These claims included the hypothesis that women tend to lead language change, which has indeed proved to be a strong tendency, for example, in the history of English. The change from taketh to takes is a good example of this. As well as using standard corpus linguistic methods, historical sociolinguists often collaborate with computer scientists to use and further develop state-of-the-art computational methods. This is because the data we use is quite challenging. Historical corpora that include information on the social background of the writers are typically relatively small and biased in a number of ways. The multidisciplinary collaboration between linguists, computer scientists, and sometimes historians as well is what places historical sociolinguistics within the paradigm of the digital humanities. While historical sociolinguists are used to using small and carefully compiled corpora that are as socially representative as possible, we're also interested in the massive historical print text databases that are increasingly used in the digital humanities. This big data can help us to answer questions that would be impossible to study in smaller corpora, and also to discover questions of interest to both linguists and historians. For instance, in my current project, we're studying how innovations related to the language of commercial society spread in 18th century publishing networks by using metadata from the English short title catalogue combined with the full text database of 18th century collections online. This research is at the intersection of historical sociolinguistics, intellectual history, and book history, and it also requires data scientists to develop new ways of analysing this big and messy data. I believe that this type of multidisciplinary research is key to gaining a more nuanced understanding of the past.